Hello, welcome in chemical education series. In this video, we are going to see some experimental part related to the potentiometry. And it is one of the application that is to determine the pKa value of the potentiometer. Our aim is to determine or do determination of pKa value of the given monobasic acid. Now, for example, we are taking the acetic acid as a monobasic acid and we have to measure the pKa value by obtaining the pH from the solution by measure with the help of potentiometer. Now we know that the acetic acid dissociates into the acetate ion and hydrogen ion. And for equilibrium constant for this acid is equal to Ka is equal to the concentration of acetate ion into concentration of hydrogen ion divided by concentration of the acetic acid present in the solution. Now to measure the pKa value, we have to measure the half neutralization point from the graph, and for this half neutralization point is the dissociation constant of an acid, and from that we can calculate the measure the pH, and from that pH at the neutralization point is the pKa value of the monobasic acid. For this we have to use this formula, the pH equal to E dot Q minus E cal minus E observed divided by 2.03 RT upon F. Now, with the help of this formula, we have to measure the E observed. We can calculate E cal with the help of standardization of potentiometer and with the help of the buffer, that is potassium hydrogen phthalate. And from that, we can calculate the pH of the observed from the observed EMF. And from the pH at the neutralization point, half neutralization point is the pKa value of the that acid. Now, for this, we required the solutions like 0.05 molar potassium hydrogen phthalate solution, 0.5 normal NaOH solution, 0.1 normal given acid, that is a monobasic acid, that is acetic acid we have taken here, twin hydrogen powder and potentiometer. Now, this potentiometer containing the two electrodes, the platinum electrode and calomel electrode. We required the magnetic stirrer also to stir the twin hydrogen powder into the beaker. Now, in this case, the procedural part, the first part is the standardization of potentiometer. This is required for every experiment of the potentiometer. For standardization of potentiometer, on the potentiometer, the knob is, we have to turn on the standard. And then, if the potentiometer gives the value 1.0185 volt, then your potentiometer is the standard potentiometer. Now this value is given because the Wheatstone bridge is kept inside that, and that cell gives the secondary potential difference. And if it is a same value given by the instrument, then the potentiometer is standardized. This is the first part of the procedure. The second part of the procedure where we have to determine the E-cal, because we are using the calomel electrode. With the help of this calomel electrode, we have to measure the potential of the E calomel with the help of this potassium hydrogen phthalate as a standard buffer solution. In this case, in this experiment, we have to take a beaker. In the beaker, we have to add the standard 0.05 molar potassium hydrogen phthalate solution, and we have to add the twin hydrogen powder in the solution. And we have to stir it to make the saturated twin hydrogen powder. And then we have to dip the calomel electrode and potential platinum electrode to make a twin hydrogen electrode, and which is connected to the respective terminal. That is, calomel electrode is connected to the negative electrode and the platinum electrode is connected to the positive electrode. And then we have to change the knob from the standard to cell. And then this connection starts to measure the EMF between these two electrodes. Now in this way, we are measuring the potential difference, that is EMF for the potassium hydrogen phthalate, which is observed at 0.201 volt, and that is the standard for the potassium hydrogen phthalate. And from that, we can we can use this value to calculate the E-cal, that is E-calomel for the solution.
What is KHP?
Yes, KHP is the potassium hydrogen phthalate. It is a weak acid, and the salt of the acid. This is act as a buffer, and this is the primary standard in the laboratory. And therefore, we are using the potassium hydrogen phthalate solution, which shows the exactly equal to the pH equal to the 4 at for the 0.05 molar solution. This is the primary standard in the laboratory. And therefore, we can use the potassium hydrogen phthalate for measurement of the calomel with the help of potentiometers. Now, in this way, the third part, that is the exact titration between the 0.5 molar normal NaOH with the 0.1 normal acetic acid solution, monobasic weak acid solution. Now, here the concentration is related to 0.1 normal acetic acid solution. And in this case, we have to use the 5 times larger concentration for the NaOH. Now, here cell is written as like this. It requires the 0.5 normal NaOH from the burette, 0.1 normal solution in the acetic acid of the taken into the beaker. We have to add the quinine hydrogen powder and we have to stir to make the saturated solution. That's why the platinum electrode dipped into this saturated quinine hydrogen electrode. Therefore, we are preparing the quinine hydrogen electrode, which is connected to the positive terminal to the potentiometer. In this way, the setup is like this. And then we have to measure by after addition of the 0.3 ml of NaOH for each time, we have to stir its solution and then we have to measure the potential difference, that is electromotive force from the instrument continually. Now, in this way, once you measure the EMF for potassium hydrogen phthalate, from that, with the help of this equation, we can substitute these values and we have to measure the E observed for the potassium hydrogen phthalate solution. From that, we can calculate the E cal by knowing the all values for the potassium hydrogen phthalate solution. From that, we can calculate the determination of E cal. And after observation of the all solutions, we have to add 0.3 ml NaOH from the burette. And then continually, we have to add measure the EMF of the solution from the potentiometer. Now, for each observation, we are measuring the potentiometer EMF. And it is observed that it is continuously decreasing the potential difference. We have to, at least we have to take the 20 observations like that after the 0.3 ml addition of the NaOH from the burette. Then we have to measure the change in the EMF, that is in between these, the differences we have to write here. After writing here, the differences is like this, up to the 20 observations, we have to write the delta E. Then delta V, that is the difference between this delta V, that is a 0.3 difference is there because we are adding the 0.3 ml every time. Then delta E upon delta V, we have to calculate. And we observe that for this observation, these are the delta E upon delta V. And after that, the mean V, that is a volume is added. The mean between that mean volume is calculated here. In this way, the mean V is observation table. We are completing up to the 20, at least 20 observations. We have to take the observation from the potentiometer as a measurement of EMF. After that, we have to plot the graph. First graph is related to the ml of added NaOH versus the EMF observed. And another graph, delta EF by delta V versus the mean volume. Now, in this way, we have to plot the graph. First graph is related to the volume of the NaOH added versus the delta E by delta V. And it is observed that the delta E by delta V, as volume is added, go on increases and up to certain point, and again it decreases like this. And second graph, that is a volume of the NaOH added and whatever the observed EMF is there on this axis, then it is observed that initially the EMF of the solution is maximum, then it's gone decreases, it crosses the zero, and then in the negative side, it is observed. Now, this is the shape of the graph is like this. Now, from the first graph, we know that what is the X, that's the neutralization point of the titration. Now, from that, the half neutralization point, that is X by 2, from that point, we have to extrapolate this line, and then at this point, this is the half neutralization voltage. That is a half neutralization point is here, and this whatever the E observed is on the graph, that is the E observed at the half neutralization point. Now, once you calculate the E observed, E cal, from that we can calculate substitute the value of the E cal, E observed from the graph and calculate the pH of the solution at E half, that is the potential half. At this position, whatever the EMF is there, this is the E observed. This value we have to substitute here, and E cal is known. And from that, we can calculate the pH of the solution. And we know that the at neutralization, half neutralization point, what is the pH of the solution is the dissociation constant of the weak acid. And therefore, pH is equal to pKa at the half neutralization point. And this is our aim, to determine the pKa value of the monobasic acid. Now, in this way, we can write the result E observed for the 0.05 molar potassium hydrogen phthalate solution, then E cal for the electrode, then E observed corresponding to the half neutralization point, E half, and pKa value of the given monobasic weak acid. If you have any doubt in this experiment, then you can ask.
What is half neutralization point?
Yes, just now I am telling here with the help of graph. Now this x value, this peak is for, this is the derivative, the graph of the derivative of the E observed with the volume change with respect to the volume added. Now this x gives the value of the neutralization point. And we know that half neutralization point is the difference between the, exactly the bit in between the neutralization point and the origin. And in between that, the half x, the value of half x, we have to extrapolate here, and we can find out here the E observed. This is for E half, that is called as a electrode E observed, or that is a EMF for the half neutralization point. Okay, and this value we have to substitute in the equation, and from that we can calculate the pH. And this is the pH is exactly equal to the pKa value at half neutralization point. Okay, then we have to write the answers here in the result table. Okay, thank you.